is a great event. And, you know, about 2,200 years ago, one of the major concerns that we had was the fundamental right to choose our faith. And in the land of Israel, 2,400 years ago, we overcome great odds. And as you know, this is the major miracle of Hanukkah. It's a miracle of the human spirit. And here we are 2,200 years later, and still one of the major fundamental issues in our world is human beings still being denied the right to their freedom of religion, and many people being killed because of their religion. So as we are trying to figure out how to light the Hanukkah candles tonight, we have to figure out a way of making sure that everyone, wherever they may be, will be able to light and to celebrate their religion the way that they choose. The only question now is get it over with so we can get the food, so we're coming there. So today, when we look at some of the bleak things that have happened in the aftermath of what happened in Paris and what happened in California and so many things that have happened over the course of the last number of years, we say, how are we going to get over it? We can't let ourselves get deterred. We can't let ourselves get despondent. And the message of Hanukkah really rings quite forcefully with us. Namely, the odds may look insurmountable, but in the end, look who's laughing. In the end, here we have a Jewish community, which at that point in time, nobody would give them a plug nickel for their chance, lighting a menorah in the front of very distinguished people who lead our country in the very breadbasket of Canada's capital in City Hall. This is something which is beyond miraculous. So tonight, when we light, we are celebrating the human capacity for overcoming the forces of evil and prevailing. So to all of you that are here tonight, God bless you. Happy Hanukkah. And now let's get on with the lighting. Before we did this, we found out, I want to tell the mayor, that Rabbi Boyarsky and I, we checked out, we found out who we voted for mayor, so it's okay. So we're good. A number of years ago when we got together, I told you that Hanukkah is all about light. It's all about taking the dark and making it light. And a person who sheds light when it is dark is called in Hebrew a Meir. That's the name for a person who sheds light. Meir sounds a lot like Mayor. And we thank the mayor for being a source of light and inspiration to our community for so many years. The truth of the matter is that the life of the Jews around Hanukkah was not in danger because the Assyrian king said to us, not a problem. You want to be like us? Fine. Don't want to be like us? Not so fine. We had a choice and we chose to fight. And what happened is this Hanukkah became a beacon of hope for all peoples in all civilizations, in all generations, including today. As we stand here today, there are many people who are not free to observe their religion. There are many countries which subjugate and do not allow people to freely express their religious belief. So if the message of Hanukkah 1,000 years ago could go thousands of miles today, and be an inspiration to people who are looking at it and saying, what, the odds are stacked against us, we'll never make it. Well, think about how this, the odds of us making it against the mighty army that we were arrayed against then, we had maybe 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 people against a tremendous army, started like this. And it ended up that we were able to win militarily against all odds. There was no odds maker then in Nevada, in Las Vegas, anywhere in the world who would give a plug nickel for us making it. And here we did. And the reason why is because the will the will and the strength of our belief were so strong that we were able to overcome. And we hope and pray that for people today who are in positions where they cannot even see a tomorrow because it's so bleak, that they will take heart from what Hanukkah is as a universal message. If you really believe in it strongly, and if you fight with all that you got, and you have people behind you that will support you, the impossible becomes possible. Thank you very much, and happy Hanukkah.